Hi, my name is Aina and I'm 8 years old. I live in Southport in the northwest of England by the Irish Sea.
Our first video showed you that coasts can be made of rock or sand or mud.
Plants and animals can help build coasts too, like coastal dunes, estuaries, deltas, coral reefs, barriers, mangroves and more. Many of these environments are connected to each other by the sea. They are like networks. For example, imagine a coastline with cliffs on one side, a river, and dunes and beaches on the other side. The cliffs are made of rock. Over time, the rocks break down into smaller rocks and sand and mud, which we call sediment. The sediment goes out to sea and the powerful movement of the water moves it along the coast like a river or a luggage belt at an airport. This is called a longshore drift. Rivers also bring sediment into the coast where it is transported by the longshore drift. Waves can carry some of the sediment out of the longshore drift to the shore where it builds up beaches and dunes. Some of the sediment keeps going alongshore to build other coastal environments. There is also sediment jumping off the longshore drift and out to sea or into it. The sediment is always on the move, with the longshore drift taking it from cliffs or estuaries to beaches and marshes and places that need it. Let's have a look around Liverpool Bay. Here is the Sefton coast where I live.
Hello!
Our coast is super important for our towns and cities, for exploring and having nature adventures, and for enjoying the outdoors. There are many coastal environments in Liverpool Bay, like the estuaries of the River Mersey and the Ribble and the Dee. We also have wetlands like Marshside, and beaches and dunes like the Sefton Dunes, which is the largest coastal dune field in England. Many special plants and animals live on our coast or come to visit every year. Our coastal environments are made up of a lot of sediment, but where is the sediment coming from? Some of our sediment comes from the sea, some comes from the rivers, and some comes from other coastal areas. The longshore drift picks the sediment up and moves it around the coast. And it also moves animals and plants that are in the water. So next time you find an animal at the beach, remember that it could be coming from somewhere else. But that is not all. Large coastal areas are also connected by sea currents, which transport sediment and plants and animals and even temperature and salt and oxygen all over the world. So next time you are at the beach, or visit a cliff, or a marsh, or an estuary, remember that they are special places that are connected to each other in big coastal networks. And that is all from me. Please remember to send this episode to your friends and families. Bye!